Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's learn how to use the clone tool in Pixelmator. Now every time somebody demonstrates a clone tool, they always start off by using a field of flowers. We're going to do the same thing. It's easy to clone a flower and make it look like it's part of the original photo. So in Pixelmator, you're going to choose the clone tool, which is right here. And the first thing that you need to do is to find an area to pull from, the clone source. This is going to be the area that's going to copy pixels from and then put them where we draw them. So let's pick a flower out here. Let's use this one since it's kind of by itself. I'll click there and you can see now that the tool has changed. There's no plus sign in the middle of it and I can start drawing with it and it will draw from the area that I've selected. So I'll be able to draw and you can see the little plus sign where the source is being taken from. So I can kind of copy that there and draw this flower down in here and even draw all the way to the stem. And I can continue to color in as much as I want. So I've kind of cloned this flower over to here. It works better in some cases than others, but it's a really good demonstration to explain what the clone tool is. Now here's a more practical application. Here's a piece of clip art I found that I think will make a great background in a keynote presentation I'm doing. But unfortunately it's got some scribble on the sheet here and I want it to be blank so that I can put in whatever I want. Well, a lot of different ways I can get rid of that. One is I could simply select there and delete it. Of course that's going to make a hole there, a transparent hole. So what I would do is bring up the colors here so I can see color and I could use white and I can do Command and Delete. It will fill with the primary color. Actually we don't want to do that. I'm going to use the eyedropper here. There we go. I'm going to change the primary color to white. If I do Command and Delete, it fills it with white, but you can see clearly there that white is not the right color. This is an off-white. So even if I were to use the eyedropper tool again and say grab somewhere in there, you can see it's got that kind of gray feel to it. I can do Command Delete and it will take it away and it seems to be okay, but if I look a little closer at it, I can see that there's kind of a offset there. That it's not quite, it's like a gradient going from one end to the other. And I could see a little edge, I don't know if it comes through in the video, I can see where that square is I've deleted. So that's not going to work. So let me undo here. And let's use the clone tool, which will allow us to create a more natural fill for it. I'm going to click on that and I'm going to take an area just below and to the right here. And that's going to be the clone area. And I'm going to draw with it. And you can see it's a little more natural now. And I'm going to stop and I'm going to hold the Option key down and take another clone area from here and draw with that. I'm going to take another cloned area from there, draw with that. And it's making it so it's indistinguishable. You can't even see where it is. I deleted it. It's because I was pulling colors in from the surrounding area. This works great with patterns and different things and different shades of like a background color like this. And here's another example. Here I've got a photo of a close-up on some grass and I want to I'm going to get rid of this one here because it kind of is cropped off by the top so it makes the photo look awkward. You can see that I've got no way to color in a fill here. This is kind of a weird pattern, a cloudy pattern back there. So I'm going to use the clone tool to clone from the right side here and then draw over. See how it nicely gets rid of it. Now I'm getting close to this other blade of grass. So for here I'm going to kind of clone from the upper left and delete that. And you can see it started to clone off part of this. So I stopped and I'm going to clone from the upper right. And you can see I can delete it there. And there you go. I've deleted that blade of grass that kind of sticks out and gets cropped off and made for a nicer image. So there's a look at the clone tool in Pixelmator. The nice thing about the clone tool is just about any image editing program like Photoshop for instance has a clone tool in it and use it pretty much the same way. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.